Hello everyone, welcome to my channel, and today we are here to discuss about one of the most important subjects considered, and that is geology. So as I have noticed, whether you talk about YouTube or any other online sources, I never found any source, any video lecture on the internet which actually taught geology in an integrated and dedicated manner. See, at one place you may find someone teaching a separate topic of geology, someone teaching only a single branch of geology, but no one has actually taught the whole syllabus covering all the branches, all the topics of geology in an integrated manner, on a single window, on a single channel. So through these lectures, I'm actually going to provide you all the basic concepts, all the topics covering all the major branches of geology all together in a single channel. Okay, now if you are doing your undergraduate, bachelor's of sciences from geology, or post graduation from geology, or even if you have taken geology as your optional subject for UPSC examinations, I think these lectures are going to help you really very well, because all the concepts and all the questions which could be asked from geology, I'm going to cover in all these lectures. So this is the first video where we are talking about the introduction of geology. It's an introductory lesson. Here we are going to study, we are going to see that what are all the topics and branches which we are going to cover in our further lectures, and what actually geology is. Fine. So now let's start at first with the definition of geology. Okay, so let's have a look at the definition. So geology is actually made up of two words, geo and logos. Geo means earth and logos means speech or study. So friends, geo plus logos is what you get as geology, and geology is the study of earth, right? Now let's look at the definition. Geology is an earth science concerned with the solid earth, the rocks of which it is composed, and the processes by which they change over time. So in very simple words, if we talk about geology, it is the science which is devoted to the study of the earth. Okay, so study of earth, it deals with all the features of the earth's surface. It is the study of the earth which deals with the features of the surface, origin, composition, structure, and inhabitants of earth. Fine. So geology is actually the study of earth, the earth's features related to the surface, origin, composition, structure, and inhabitants of earth. So that is what geology is. Now let's look at the important branches of geology. Like the other subjects, geology also has the branches of its own. Fine. Now at first let's look at the first geology branch, that is physical geology. Physical geology is actually concerned with the physical processes, and the physical properties of earth, its surrounding space environment, and use of quantitative methods for their analysis. So in very simple terms, if we talk about physical geology is concerned with the work of natural processes. Natural processes which bring about changes upon the earth's surface. Okay? After physical geology, let's talk about petrology. See, in the first introductory lecture where we are talking about the branches of geology, here we are not actually going very deep into them. Why? Because here we are actually studying just a brief introduction of these branches, right? Afterwards, in the further lectures, we'll be covering all these branches, the important topics and the syllabus under them separately. So just for now, no need to panic if you find any word which seems very difficult to you. Just have a little bit of introduction about these branches, because afterwards in the further lectures, we are actually going to cover them separately. Fine? Now the next one is petrology. Petrology is actually related to the study of rocks. So it studies the origin, composition, distribution and structure of rocks. So petrology actually deals with rocks. Then comes mineralogy. Mineralogy name itself suggests that it is something related to the minerals. So the study of minerals, its composition and properties, that is what we study in mineralogy, the composition and properties of minerals. Fine. The next branch is structural geology. See the word structure here. And in structural geology, we are actually going to deal with the three-dimensional distribution of rock units with respect to their deformational history, or very in simple words, we can say that it deals with the study of the structure of rocks. The name itself suggests structure of rocks. Fine. See, a word tectonic is used here. There's a topic, tectonic plates. In the further lectures, there we'll be learning about what tectonic actually is. For now, just know that structural geology deals with the structure of rocks. And after that, let's come to another branch, that is stratigraphy. See, stratigraphy is made up of the word strata. Strata means layers. Fine? So it studies the rock layers, stratas, and layering, that is stratification. So the layers are called as stratas, and the layering is called as stratification. So it is primarily used in the study of sedimentary and layered volcanic rocks. See, when we will be studying about sedimentary rocks, they will study that sedimentary rocks are actually found in layers. Okay, that's why in stratigraphy we are actually going to deal with the sedimentary and layered volcanic rocks. So this is what stratigraphy is. The next important branch is paleontology. Paleontology, it simply deals with the study of fossils. Okay, it deals with the study of fossils. So it is simply the study of ancient life. Ancient life here doesn't mean those early man civilizations, fine? Ancient life here actually means the fossils, the study of fossils to determine organisms' evolution and interactions, the organisms' evolution and interaction with each other and their environments, which is also called as paleoecology, right? The next one is crystallography. Crystallography, something striking the mind related to crystals, right? So, crystallography is the experimental science of determining the arrangement of atoms in the crystalline solids. So, in crystallography, we are actually learning about the arrangement of atoms in what? In crystals, or say it, crystalline solids. Guys, don't look at my handwriting. I know it's not coming so neat, but I think you can understand it, right? So, coming to another branch, that is mining geology. See guys, mining geology, engineering geology, and hydrology, these are actually the applications of the other branches which we have already studied. It is actually the application of geology which we are going to study in these branches. Okay, so first one is mining geology. It is an applied science. Just now I told you applications, which is related to what? The principles of economic geology and mining engineering. So combining these principles, we actually apply mining geology, okay, to the development of a defined mineral resources. Regarding the minerals, we'll be actually covering regarding everything about the minerals in the mineralogy and crystallography, and about their further applications we are going to study all these things in mining geology. Okay, the next is engineering geology. Is the application of, it is also application based branch, scientific methods and engineering principles to the acquisition, interpretation and use of knowledge of materials of the earth's crust and earth's material for the solution of engineering problems and design of engineering work. It is actually related to engineering geology. So for the students who are actually doing graduation and post graduation here, you don't need to go much deeper about the engineering principles, but whatever it is related to the concepts of geology, we'll be dealing all those things here. Okay, the next one is hydrology. Hydro, what is hydro? Remember something? Yeah, it is water. Hydro means water. So here we are going to study actually about water, not proper water, but yeah, the movement, distribution and quality of water on earth and other plants. This is what we are going to study in hydrology, including the hydrological cycle, that is what, the water cycle, water resources and environmental watershed sustainability. Okay, sustainability, what? Sustainable development, utilizing the resources without actually harming the needs of the future. Okay, that is sustainability. Now, if you are a geology student, it is really important for you to actually know what are the scopes of geology. Alright, if you are planning to become a geologist or whatever, you should actually know that whatever you are studying, what are its scopes, what are its practical applications and how it is important to the humans, to the mankind. Okay, so when we talk about the scopes of geology, the first thing we are going to look at here is that, see, it is of immense practical importance to mankind. How? See, in the previous branches, when I told you, I had talked to you about the branches of geology, there we have seen many applications of some branches like the mining geology, engineering geology and so on. So saying that geology is of practical importance to mankind means that it plays a very useful part in the search of important resources for the existence of mankind. See, it plays a very important role in search of coal, petroleum, minerals, atomic fuels, fossil fuels, right? And it is directly concerned with the ore minerals, the industrial minerals, the mining industry. So if you talk about the economics, if you talk about the existence of mankind, so many things are related to geology. Fine, like see, just here in this mining industry, we have learned about the mineralogy, we have learned crystallography. I mean, we'll be learning crystallography, mining, and economic geology. So the principles of all these branches are applicable in the mining industry. The same goes with civil engineering. All the dams, bridges, tunnels. What do you think? What these engineers do? They go anywhere around the world, and at any region they start digging up tunnels, they start making bridges, or they start making dams. No, actually, these all things, when they are going to be constructed, at first we have to look at the geology of that region, right? So these important applications of geology are applicable in civil engineering, also in petroleum engineering, identifying the areas where petroleum, where fossils can be found, where oil and natural gas can be found, where petrol can be found. There we are actually applying the principles of geology, right? In environment engineering, in oceanography, hydrology, what we study. Other things also, in oceanography you study about the marine life also. There you'll get to know about some fossils also. In space exploration, something related to your physical geology. So I mean, not a single branch of geology is applicable to each of them, but a combined knowledge of geology is necessary for all these scopes, right? So after the scope of geology, let's look at another very important frequently asked question from the students, that geology and geography are same. I mean, whatever you study in geology, it's more or less same like geography. But friends, no, geology is not geography. If you are a geology student or if you are a geography student, you really need to know the difference between the two, because they are not the same. Yeah, they have some similarities, they have some common topics in them, like the geomorphology. That is the same topic in both geology and geography, but there are many differences between them, and that's why you say that geology is not geography, right? Talking about the first difference, it's the definition. Geology is the study of the earth, its composition, processes, history, and even its future, right? So you are just here mainly concerned about the earth composition, the processes going on. And so there you are not concerned about the human and their relationship with the environment and all. But in geography is the study of places and the relationships between people and their environment. So basically here you are establishing a relationship between the biological aspects as well as your environment. Okay, so geographers explore both the physical properties of Earth's surface and the human societies spread across it. Fine, so here you are actually concerned with the human societies, the flora, fauna, vegetation and all, but in geology that's not the case. Okay, so next difference if you talk about is that geology is primarily the study of subsurface, whereas geography, it deals with the surface of the earth. Here the surface of the earth and geology the subsurface of the earth and geography the surface of the earth. Fine. Now in geology, the next important difference is that the morphology means the shape and structure of the earth's surface, which is directly influenced by geological processes like erosion, tectonic activity, etc. These will be learning in the further lectures, don't worry. So a basic knowledge of geology helps understanding the evolution of Earth's surface. To understand the evolution of Earth's surface, you need to have a basic knowledge of geology, because the evolution, erosion, origin, composition and all are linked to the geology, not geography. I mean, in geography, you would be learning about मॉर्फोलॉजी, सी ज्योग्राफी, बट इट इज़ नॉट लिमिटेड टू मॉर्फोलॉजी एज इट एक्सटेंड्स टू स्टडी ऑफ रीजनल वेजिटेशन, फ्लोरा, फौना, पोलिटिकल बाउंड्रीज, प्रेजेंस एंड चेंजेस इन वाटर बॉडीज एट्सेट्रा. इन जियोलॉजी यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द वेजिटेशन, फ्लोरा एंड फौना. या या हियर यू आर लर्निंग अबाउट द फॉसिल्स, बट देट इज़ द एंशियंट लाइफ, राइट. बट इन जियोग्राफी यू आर एक्चुअली कंसर्न्ड अबाउट द वेजिटेशन, द फ्लोरा एंड फौना. या इन लाइक इन जियोलॉजी यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द पोलिटिकल बाउंड्रीज ऑफ द कंट्रीज, but in geography you are actually concerned with them. So that's why you say that geology and geography are not same. So guys, with this we complete the first introductory video of our geology lectures. In the next video I'll be giving you the topics and the syllabus which we are going to cover in the further lectures of geology, fine. And I hope in the further lectures, in the further videos, you'll be able to grasp all the things properly, all your doubts, all your queries would be clear. And if there is any doubt, there is any query, you're free to contact me, you're free to post your question in the comment section. So guys, study well and keep enjoying the geology lectures. Thank you so much.